Good evening, everyone. Welcome to another webinar in the series of webinars from Canara Entrepreneurs. Canara Entrepreneurs is a global nonprofit mutual benefit corporation chartered by individuals from the Canara region. It is mainly founded for the to support and nurture entrepreneurship. It was formed in the year 2004. It has expanded through affiliations to cover all key locations with individuals from having similar objectives. We have three chapters in Dubai, Bangalore, and a virtual chapter. We have about 425 members across these chapters. Our objectives are mentoring, welfare, personal growth, wealth creation and preservation. Members get the benefit to access the KE app, connect with various other members in different industries, collaborate with other members of KE. We have a website and social media. These are the coordinates. So, coming back to our webinar today, Roshan, you'll present the first screen. We have Roshan Sequeira from Quant Tower Technologies. Quant Tower provides multi-asset, multi-connect trading platform with an access to Indian and global markets. Roshan has about 30 years of financial market experience as an investor and trader, having traded most of the asset classes, actively involved in derivatives trading over the last 9 years, and also providing consultancy services to private clients, deploying their funds in arbitrage and spread trading strategies, foreign exchange and index derivatives. Roshan will be conducting our webinar today and presenting his application on derivatives trading and optimizing your portfolio through derivatives, specifically options. Derivatives are not something that is the flavor for everyone. It contains and does possess higher risk, but there is good opportunity to earn good revenue if you understand math and the nuances of derivatives. Now I now hand over to Roshan.
Just a second, Ajay. Ajay, can you close your screen?
Yeah, go ahead, Roshan. Yeah.
Can you see my screen?
Yeah, it's visible, yes.
Thanks, Ajay, for introducing me, and I would like to thank KE for giving me this opportunity to showcase what option trading can do and how you can optimize the portfolio to gain additional return on your investment. You can also use the option trading to build your portfolio on a regular basis, steadily, to increase the return on investment, or as well as to manage your risk whenever you see the. Pardon? Hello?
I think Adrian said he cannot hear. I can hear, it's audible, but maybe a little louder would be better.
Okay. Can you hear me better now?
Yeah, it is clear to me.
It's clear to me also, yes.
Okay, so I don't know how many of you know about option trading, or have you traded the markets? Most of us know that, you know, we are involved with the stock market, but I assume that many of you may not be trading the option trading. So I would like to start with the basics of options, and then I will.
Can we do a quick poll of those who have traded options and those who have not for a minute? There is a reaction icon on the bottom of your screen. Just click the thumbs up button if you have traded options or have invested in options before, so we can get an idea of what we are dealing with. Are you seeing the, yeah, we have one. Two. Okay, we have about two out of 20 who have dealt with options. So you know what you're dealing with. So there's a lot to learn and good potential to learn from this particular webinar.
Okay, I will start with the introduction and I will go a little deep into the basics of options.
Yeah.
So to start with, options is a contract, is an agreement between a buyer and a seller, which gives the right but not the obligation to buy or sell a specific asset. When you say assets, it could be shares, index, commodity, or currency, or bonds, etc., at a specific strike price on or before the expiration date. Option sellers are obligated to buy or sell the underlying security as per the option contract terms. So when I say if you are a buyer of an option, it could be a call option or a put option. Okay, it's an agreement that you will buy or sell, but not necessarily an obligation that, you know, even if the option is exercised, you are not required to take honor that obligation. However, as a seller of an option, be it a call or a put, if the buyer wants to exercise the option, okay, he has to honor that commitment or agreement. Okay. So every option contract is associated with a premium or a cost. And the contract has three main components that determine the premium. So the three components are the underlying price of the security. So if you are trading in stock options, the stock price of that particular security is the underlying price. The strike price at which you would like to buy or sell the call or a put option. Now I'll come back to that later, what is call and put and how you can, what is strike price. And then there is an expiration date, which date the contract will be settled. Okay. So there are, when it comes to exercising the option, there are ways that option can be exercised. It can be before the expiration date or on the date of expiration date. So in the case of Indian markets, they are European options. Okay, so the expiration date is the exercise date. However, in the case of US markets, the buyer can exercise the option anytime he wants. Okay, and the seller or seller of the option has to honor this commitment. So let's talk about call option. So when I'll first show the option chain, so which will give you a better understanding about what call options are and put options. So if you could see here, this is the last traded price of TCS. Okay, this is when I say TCS, this is the underlying price of TCS, the stock price itself. This was a screenshot of yesterday. Okay, and these are the prices that you can see out here. Here you can see the expiration date. So I'm looking at the expiration date, which is 24th of February, which is 28 days to go since yesterday. And these are the strike prices at which you can buy or sell the call option or put option. Okay. So this is the exercise price. The current price of the stock is 3690. So when you say 3690, this is the price of the stock. And if it is trading closest to that, we call it at the money strike. And all the strikes that you see, which is highlighted on the left side, are in the money calls, which means they have some money over and above the premium. Like, you know, so there is a premium involved in it. So if you see here, there is 100 and if you look at 3680 is the strike price, and you can see the premium for this particular strike. Okay. Now you can buy this or sell this. So this is a call option. And all those call options that are not highlighted are out of the money call options. Similarly, if you're looking at the put option, you can see the highlighted are above 3,700 and not highlighted are below those prices. So we call the in the money put options are these and out of the money put options are these. So if you want to buy a stock, for example, so you can participate in the market by buying the share itself, right? So you can buy this particular stock at whatever the price that is available currently. Or if you think that you are expecting the market to go up, but you do not want to invest the entire amount of that value. So if it is 3,600, the contract size of TCS is about 150 shares. So it's a big amount for you to invest. Okay, so if you want to participate in the market, if based on your view, so if, whether it is a bullish view or a bearish view, so you can participate in the options as well. So when you look at the strike price here, suppose I'm bullish about the market, I can buy a call option or I can sell a put option. Okay, so I'll come back to that later. I don't want to make it complicated right now. So let's look at first the call option. When you're buying a call option, suppose you decide that you want to buy this call option having a strike price of 3680. Okay. So what will happen? The current price is 3690. The strike price that you want to buy is 3680. And the premium that you need to pay for this particular call option is 110 rupees. Okay. So which means to make money on this particular call option, the price has to go 3680 plus 110 rupees. So 3790. Only then you will start breaking even from this particular call option. Now, what will happen is that, you know, if you have a very good view on the market, you can buy because it will allow you to participate in the market at a very low investment. But it also has a very high premium as well. So what you one can do is if you're very bullish that the market can go probably 3,800, 3,900, yes, you can buy this call option. And at the time of expiration date, if the price is above 3,790, you will be in profit. Otherwise, you lose that particular premium. So now you will not lose entirely. You lose the premium entirely only if the price closes below 3,680. So I will explain with the example at later how exactly your risk reward with every options when you're buying or selling the call or put option. So similarly, if you're anticipating that the market will fall, you could buy the put option or you can sell the call option. Okay. So let's go back to the risk reward here. So you can see here, suppose the price of the stock is at 100 rupees or $100. Okay. And the premium for this is 5 rupees. So your break even is 5 rupees. So 105 rupees. Let's assume that at the time of expiration date, if the price of the stock is below 105, so this is your payoff graph. So which means if the price is at 104, you will lose only 1 rupee from your trade. If it's at 100, you will lose nothing. You will lose 5 rupees, okay? And if it is below 100, you will lose that 5 rupees only, okay? However, if the price goes up, okay, suppose if the price is at 110, so you will gain 5 rupees from this particular trade. And even if the price goes to 120, 130, your risk is limited to 5 rupees only, whereas the gain from this particular option is going to be unlimited. However,
you might want to share for a few of our viewers what selling a put or selling a call means, because mostly in trading, they only know of buying and selling.
Okay.
Here, there are four things to do. You have buying a put, selling a put, buying a call, selling a call.
Yeah, that's right. So I'm talking about right now buying a call. So long call means buying a call. Okay. So which means you are bullish on the market. So you can participate instead of buying a share itself, you can buy a call or whatever strike you want. If you can be trading the strike price out of the money as well. So if you're expecting the market is going to be about 3,900 so you can participate out of the money call, which costs you only 66 rupees. Okay. And if the price goes to 3,900, you could gain the difference. Okay. So similarly, you can sell the call as well. So if there is a buyer, there has to be a seller as well, right? So if I'm buying a call, there has to be a seller. Okay. So that means a selling a call. Now, when a seller of a call will have this limited gain that you will lose, as a buyer, you lose only 5 rupees, whereas the seller will have unlimited risk, because if the price goes against him, he will have unlimited risk, because that you are going to gain that gain that profit. Okay. Similarly, if you lose, you will gain maximum $500 only, or as per this example, only $500. The premium that you pay is lost if the price closes below the strike price.
So a seller makes limited profit and unlimited loss, and yes, a buyer has unlimited gains but limited loss.
So same way, you can see that you can also participate as a seller of a call as well. Okay, so here your gain is limited to, if it is the same strategy that you follow, if you are selling a call, so your gain is limited to $500 and your losses can be unlimited. Okay, it's not defined here because the price can go anywhere at the time of expiry or before the expiry. Okay, so same way you can participate in the put option as well. So if you are bearish about the market, you can buy a put. So when you say buy a put, so you are buying a put, say for example, buying a put of 95, also buying a put of 100, okay? So, and you're paying a premium of $5 or 5 rupees. On 100 shares that's traded, the premium will be $500, okay? So if the price goes below 95, you will start making unlimited profit, whereas your loss is limited to the premium that is paid. So again, this depends on where the price closes at the expiry date. Same way you can do the opposite, also opposite side, you will be doing the short put. When I say short put, it is selling a put. So your gain here is limited to the premium that you receive, whereas your risk can be unlimited. Okay. So I've given an example understanding the price of a price, option price and premium. So let's assume your call strike is 100. Current price of the stock is 105. So the option premium for this particular stock is 7. So this option has an intrinsic value. So when, because the price of the stock, current price is 105. So it has an intrinsic value of five rupees and a time value of 2 rupees. Okay. So same way in call option, the strike price is 100, current price of the stock is 95. Okay, the option premium for the strike price is 100. For the strike of 100 is 2. The option has zero intrinsic value and it has only the time value because this is a out of the money option. To understand the option price and premium, there are many factors that determine the price of an option and how to price it. One is the implied volatility. So when I say implied volatility, it is the volatility of the stock itself. If the stock is volatile, the price of an option is priced higher because there is a bigger risk involved for the seller of the option. So if the implied volatility means one has to pay higher premium. Then comes the time to expiry. So if there are more days to expire this contract, there will be a lot of time premium built into this particular price. And then the price of the stock itself. So if the price of the stock is above the current, above the strike price, there is intrinsic value in this particular in this option premium. Then there are other measures that determine the premium as well. So that is delta, gamma, theta, and vega. So delta is a measure where you will see a movement of the price, movement of the premium based on the price movement of the stock. So for example, if a stock moves, say $1 or 1 rupee, and if the option premium, option strike has a delta of 0.5, which means for every rupee the stock moves, the premium will move by 50 paise. Okay. So that's how the delta decides the movement of decides the premium built into this particular option strike. So then comes the gamma, which at the measure at which the delta moves is decided by the gamma. Then theta is the time value. So every strike, the longer the strike expiry, it has a large amount of theta built into it. So closer to the expiry, this will reduce drastically. So that is where buying options, though looks limited risk and unlimited profit. This is a major factor that will make the option buyers to lose money, because even if the price remains at the same price, okay, you will start losing money because on a daily basis because of the theta. And the vega is the volatility. Again, this also is very important factor that one has to look at it. So when you enter the by buying or selling the option, say for example you're buying the option, the implied volatility was very high, for example, okay, and the implied volatility drops suddenly, so then the premium of that particular option also declines, even though the price of the stock remains at that level. So it's very important to look into all these factors. But you know, being a perfect market, the pricing of the option is not such a big concern for us, because we always know that the markets are perfect in deciding the premium. So if there is any premiums which are overpriced or undervalued, there will be a lot of arbitrage opportunities, which most of the arbitrage systems or the auto trading system will automatically adjust these prices to take advantage of this particular disparities in the pricing of the premium. So we don't have to worry much about how exactly the options are priced, but yes, these are the factors one has to look into it. Depend when you are entering the option market. So if you are a buyer of an option, if the implied volatility is very high, you can be sure that, you know, if the volatility drops, you will start losing money on that. If the expiry is far too long, so as the price as we go closer to the expiry, we will start losing that premium due to the theta decay, and the price of the stock itself can have an impact on the price, on the option premium as well. So the stock price, which was probably today at the in the money, the strike price which was in the money, if the price of the stock falls, it goes up, it will be depending on whether you're buying a call or a put, it can be in the money or out of the money. So these are the factors that you need to look at it. So what are the advantages of option trading? So one of the advantages, low capital requirement. As I told you earlier, if you want to buy a stock and participate in the market, you need a large investment. Like say, for example, if you want to buy TCS, for example, you need to buy minimum of 150 shares of TCS. If you want to buy a futures contract, you can buy shares with one share as well. However, if you want to participate in the futures market, that requires bigger investment, bigger margins as well. So you could participate with low investment depending on your view. So that's important. Second, leverage. So you can leverage your existing portfolio. So I will come back to those strategies, how you can leverage your existing portfolio and generate passive income from these using options. So there are multiple strategies that you can create to trade the options market. Okay, so it is not just buying or selling calls. You could be buying calls, selling call, put, selling call together, buying a call, selling a put. Lot of strategies can be created. There are different strategies that are available. So I will show you that as well, but we will not discuss those strategies today. I will be looking into some simple things that you can do with your portfolio. The risk reward, using option strategies, one can control risk, because if you're buying an option, you know that the amount of maximum that you can lose, and you can return your return potential on your investment over a period of time. Another thing, important thing about options is the lower commissions and costs, because even in Indian, if you want to participate in the Indian market, the commissions are charged, or the cost of trading is done on the option premium rather than on the value of the stock or option or futures contract. So if you're trading a call option or a put option, you're paying a premium or the cost, say for example, the state security transaction tax and all other costs that are there trading the markets will be drastically reduced because of the option because of the options. Disadvantages, as I said, that there will be a lot of complexities to trade options. But yes, it is difficult to start with, but I think if you could master it, there will be a lot of opportunities in options. Some of the option contracts can be very, very illiquid. For example, if you look at the stock options, okay, not all stock options are very liquid. However, the index options in most cases will be very, very liquid, okay? The time decay, as I said, the theta decay that I was talking about. So that is a very big disadvantage if you're buying the option. And then if you're a seller of an option, you have unlimited risk as well. So these, whatever risk that you have can be covered by using hedging of the positions that you do. That's where we do a lot of strategies when you do the option trading, and you reduce the risk associated with the option trading. So in the next subsequent webinars, probably we can look at how you can use these strategies to reduce the risk associated with the option trading. If at all you're doing purely as a trading in instead of hedging or using your portfolio, if you want to do option trading purely as a trading opportunity, so you could use those strategies to minimize the risk. We can discuss that in the next webinars if at all we conduct. And who should trade options and why? So one of the important thing that you can look at trading options is to diversify your risk, diversify your portfolio. You can use option as your as another asset class. At the same time, you can use options to reduce your risk as an hedging mechanism. Low investment is another the advantage that you have. And this, if you are able to trade options properly with the proper plan, the returns can be much higher than trading any other asset class. And another thing is, if you want to build a portfolio using options and manage the portfolio very well, you can use these option strategies that I'm going to talk about today to steadily build your portfolio, manage the risk, and gain additional return on investment. So these are some of the strategies that we trade. So there are many things that we have. It will be very much complicated right now when you look at it, so many strategies. But I think if you could, I'm going to only talk about covered call today and cash secured put, which directly connects to your portfolio, or if at all you want to invest, how you can gain from this. So when I say, I'll talk about covered call first. Okay. So let me show you a screen. So this is an Apple stock, which I took a screenshot, I think on the 19th of January, okay? The Apple stock was quoting at around $168, okay? So suppose what happens is that you have an Apple stock, okay? So when you trade in the US market, you will be trading in the multiples of 100 shares. Whereas in the case of Indian markets, when you trade options, there is a specific lot for every stock. So it can vary from stock to stock depending on the type of stock that you're taking. So for example, if you trade TCS, it'll be 150 shares minimum that you trade and in multiples. So if you trade Reliance, it could be about 250 shares. So there is a lot size as well. So in the case of US markets, it is 100 is a standard lot size. So let's assume that you have an Apple stock in your portfolio. Okay. There are two things that you can do. Okay. So let's assume that you bought this Apple stock at say 140 rupees, maybe a few months back, okay? Now the price is 170. You do not want to sell this particular stock, okay? So what you can do, if the price, let's assume that you are okay, if the price goes to 200, you are okay to sell this particular stock. So what you can do right now is you can start selling this stock, a call option, okay, of say probably 200 premium. So what you'll gain is this particular premium that you gain, which is very, very negligible. But if you sell this particular call, so if you are okay to sell the stock at 170, for example, okay, but you do not want to sell it right now, but if the price remains above 70, you are okay to sell. So what you can do is, if you sell right at sell this particular call option, for a month you could gain this extra premium. So if the stock remains above, if the price remains above 170, okay, so you have a chance of this particular stock can be exercised by the option buyer. So if you, what you will do is, you will be selling this particular stock option, call option, and you will get this $6.55 as premium. So what will happen? Your cost will reduce by this $6.55. Okay. So let's assume that you bought this particular stock at 140. When you sell this, you will, your cost is reduced by $6.55. Okay. So even if the price goes above 170, so your gain will be not 170 minus 140. It will be 170 minus 140, and then the premium that you gave for it. Okay. So this way you can use a call option as a covered strategy. So that is what I'm talking about. If you already hold that particular stock in your portfolio. Okay. What if you do not have this particular stock, but you still want to participate in this market? So if you buy this stock at 170, you don't know what will be the price of this particular stock tomorrow, right? But you are okay to sell this particular stock if it goes to 185, for example. You can sell this particular call option and you can gain this $1.41 for a month. Okay. If the price remains below 185, this premium is yours. If the price goes above 185, so then you will gain $15 plus $1.41. So you are increasing your return on investment by doing this particular strategy. However, in this case, when you do this, it does not protect you your downside risk. If the price of the stock goes to say 140 after you bought at 170, it does not protect you from the downside. Okay. So when I say buying a call, so covered call is an option strategy that is used as with a combination of buying a call, buying a stock. So when I say long stock, buying a stock and selling a call option. Okay. So either you can buy a stock as a new investment, or you can use your existing stock to sell this particular call option. And with this, what will happen is, if you already have a portfolio in your account and if you place this particular stock in the market, you can get the margin benefit as well. So you really don't pay additional margins to trade this particular strategy. So another option is covered calls are primarily used when an investor is looking to generate passive income on a long-term portfolio holdings while reducing the position's cost basis. So when I said that you had a stock at bought at 140 and you sold at say 170 call option, you could gain a premium of $6. So now if the price goes below 170, okay, you still gain that $6, and you can steadily, if you can do this consistently, you could reduce the cost of your stock over a period of time. That's where I was saying that you could increase your return on investment. The long shares stock can be owned before selling or the covered call, or the position can be entered simultaneously by purchasing the shares and selling the call against the stock position. So when to use this particular strategy? So if you are moderately bullish on the stock, say for example, you have this stock, okay, but you're not very bullish about it because you do not want to forego this stock that you are already holding. So if you're expecting that the market will not go up, but it will not go up so much, you could look at where you are comfortable to sell this particular stock. So suppose you bought at 170, and if the price goes to 185, you're comfortable to sell this stock and even forego this particular, if the buyer exercises this particular option, you're okay to forego this particular investment. So when I say forego, you will not lose money, but you are okay to deliver the stock to the buyer of the option. So at 185, so you are going to gain that extra premium. So that's one. Okay. If you're expecting a correction, like say, for example, if you've been holding the stock and market, you know very well that the market can correct at many, many, many times. Like market will not move, go one-sided. Of course, it has gone one-sided in the recent past, but many a times you'll see a lot of corrections in this market, even on a bullish market or bullish trend. So when you're expecting a correction, you can hedge your risk by selling a covered call, okay? So against your portfolio, you sell a call option at a higher price, and it will slowly reduce your cost of investment. If you're expecting the stock to move in a range and consolidating, so if you're thinking that the stock is not going to go up or down much, you can use this strategy as well, which will pay you a lot, because if the price remains at the same price, at same level or a longer period of time, you will start gaining from this particular premium, because the theta, as the price, the days passes closer to the expiry, the theta decay will increase your return on investment. And if you want to hold the stock for long term, but willing to take the risk of downside as well. So suppose, even if you entered the stock at, say, Apple stock at 170, and you are okay to hold this particular stock for a long term, okay, you can still use this particular strategy, because if the price goes up, you could gain additional return. If the price goes down also, you will gain every month something. So covered call. So what are the strike? Like, say, when you're doing a covered call, what are the strikes that you need to select is a very important question. So strike price selection to sell the call option. You know, this depends on the expectation of return on investment. So if you're looking to do a short-term trade, like that is simultaneously purchasing a stock and selling a call option, the strike price can be as near as possible from the current price to get a higher premium. So let's assume that you bought this particular stock at 170, okay? And if the price, and you are not expecting that the price will go beyond, say, 175. So you are selling a 175 call. So you will gain this $4, okay? So, and if the price goes below this, you'll still gain this. If the price goes above, you'll gain this $5 that you already made from the difference of this particular strike, plus this additional premium that you gain. So you are not a loser if at all, if the price goes up. If the price goes down, you will be slowly reducing the cost of your investment, okay? So what are the strikes that you can look at is when I look at covered calls or to sell, I want a stock. If I want to hold this particular stock for a longer term, then I would look at stock which is having a lowest possibility of the stock price going above that particular strike price. So for example, if you look at here, you can see the delta out here, okay? So if you see the delta out here of 180 strike, the delta is about 29% to 28.36%, okay? So it's one third possibility, or less than one third possibility, that this stock price will go above $180. Okay, that is at this current stage. Okay, this delta can change, but this is the probability that the stock will not go above $180, and that the probability of this is just 30% or 28%. So I would always look at these strike price below 30%, so that, you know, I don't have to sell the stock at all. Most of the case, if you consistently do this particular strategy, you will notice that, you know, that you will, many a times you will see that there is, the stock will remain within that particular range. So even, you cannot say that, you know, we just do it one or two trades and the stock price can go above that. But if you consistently do it month after month, you will see that your probability of gaining from is 70%, because the probability of the stock going above 30% going above this particular price is only 30%. So you have a 70-30 risk reward, I would say. So this is where you could look at where exactly you need to sell a call option when you want to do a covered call strategy. So there are many stocks that are available for you to do this, But you know, you also be you have to be choosy about what stocks this strategy can be used. The only first of all, of course, you can trade this particular strategy only if the stock is traded in the options segment. In the case of Indian market, there are about 210 stocks that are available in the options segment, whereas in the US market, most of the stocks are available to be traded in the options segment. However, they may not be liquid, so it depends on what stock that you want to trade. So second, the stock is that you need to also have the stock in multiples. So like say, for example, if the lot size of that particular stock is 100, so you must buy, if you're buying fresh that particular stock, you need to buy in multiples of 100, or you must have a stock portfolio which is having more in multiples of 100. So if you have 300 shares of Apple, probably you can do three lots of covered calls. Or if you want to buy that Apple stock, you need to buy 100. But again, I'm talking from purely from a point of view of investment. But if you want to speculate, you don't have to invest, or you need to have that much of money, or you need to buy that particular stock. So risk reward, this strategy doesn't protect you from the downside. As I said, if the price of the stock goes down, it doesn't protect you the downside. But what happens is that the premium that you already gained will reduce the cost of your investment, okay? So returns are limited to the premium received. As I said, if the price of the stock goes up, okay, you may lose out on the possible gain that the stock could make because you already sold at a particular price. Anything above that, your risk, price of the stock moves above that, your returns are limited. And if the price goes above the stocks, you may have to sell that particular stock to the buyer of the option. So however, this strategy can generate steady monthly income on the portfolio, which can be much higher than the return that can be generated in a stock that is moving in a range. So I would pick a stock to do this strategy very well in stocks like that has a probably higher dividend, okay, or the stocks that moves in a very, very narrow range. So this thing can be used, okay? Or there are stocks that you think that, you know, very volatile, and those stocks will have a very big time value. So these are the stocks also that you can use for trading this strategy. So I've covered the covered call, and later on, if you have any questions, we can always discuss, and probably I can show you with more examples. So same thing now as a covered call. So like covered call, you already own a stock, or you are buying a stock and then do an option trade. Whereas in the case of cash secured put, it is like a selling a put option, okay? So for example, let's assume that the price of the stock, like for example, let's assume that you do not own a stock right now in Apple, because Apple is priced very high at this point of time. But you are okay to buy this particular stock if the Apple stock falls below $150. So what will happen? Okay, you will have the investment ready for it, but unless the price of the stock falls, you are not willing to buy because you think that the price of the stock is overvalued at this particular point, and you do not want to buy the stock at this price. So what you can do in this case is, if you're comfortable buying at 150, so at this stage, what you can do is you sell a put option at $1.2, okay? So what will happen? If the price of the stock remains above 150, you still gain something from this particular investment, okay? If the price goes down, okay, you are anyway willing to buy this particular stock at 150. You have made up your decision to buy at 150. Okay, so what will happen when you buy this particular stock at 100, if the price falls below 150, your cost of your stock will reduce by $1.2, the premium that you gained. Okay, so this way you can reduce the stock the cost of your stock by using the option strategy. If the price falls further, you probably want to average it at every $10, $20 correction. This particular stock you want to hold for long term, so you could start selling as the price goes down. You could start selling this particular option premium at the price at which you're comfortable to invest in this particular stock. So this is a very you are always at an advantage by doing this particular strategy if you are prepared to buy a stock that when the market falls. So normally we cannot time the market when it will go up. Okay. And in that bargain, there is a possibility that we may lose out the opportunity of making money in this stock. So this is a good option for you to do this by selling a put option. At least even if the price of the stock remains above, you will start making some money on that particular stock. Okay. So now we have taken a stock, which is Apple, which is having not so volatile in these recent months. But if you look at stocks like Tesla, having a very high volatility has a very huge premium. Okay, of course, I can probably show you an example of Tesla. You could see that the Tesla stock is currently at $846. Okay, and 1 month, next 1 month contract of the expiry. So you can see that the current price of the stock is about 840. Let me reduce this by less strikes. So $846 right now. Okay. But let's assume that you are okay to buy this particular stock at $800. Okay. What you can do is, so it's not changing the expiry date. Just a second. Okay, so current price of the stock is 846. Okay, and if you are comfortable buying the stock at $800, you can reduce the cost of this particular stock by selling a put option of $800. Even though the price is 48.46, it all depends on whether you're willing to buy the stock at $800. Okay. So what can happen in this case? So you sold this put option at $34. Okay, you got this premium. If the price falls below $800, so your cost of your stock is $800 minus $34. But if the price of the stock remains at $800 and above after sold this particular put, you still gain this $34. So that's an advantage you have by using this particular strategy. So this way you can steadily build your portfolio at a price that you are willing to invest in a stock. So the downside to this is that you may not get this particular stock to buy at all. You could have bought at 846 and then you could have, if the price goes to $1,000, you could have made a lot of money. But there is always a risk to buy it if you think that the price is quoting at a very high price. And so it is better that you could buy this particular stock at a lower price, you know. So using this particular strategy, you can participate in this market and try to buy the particular stock at a price that you would like to buy and still gain from this particular by selling a put option. So this is where the cash secured put comes into picture. This strategy is going to be very useful to build your portfolio over a longer period of time. So I think I've almost covered up this thing, but I can give you some examples what happened in the past. Like if you could see here in this particular slide, okay. One second. So for example, a stock like IPC, okay, which has a very high dividend yield, okay, and if you had bought at say 120, like if you had bought, like, you know, if you wanted to do a covered call strategy and you bought at 120, okay, and immediately if you had sold this particular call at 225, the premium on this particular day, which is 10 days prior to this, okay, like, you know, this was a screenshot taken on the 17th or 18th of January, the premium was only $2, okay. So price, obviously price would have fallen right now, okay. So if you see the price on the, this is on the expiry date, okay. So your 225 premium is price quoted zero, but the price of the stock has fallen to 214, okay. But this is a high dividend yielding stock. So even if the price falls, you are looking to hold this stock for a longer time. But if the price had gone up about 225, you could have gained not five rupees, but 7 rupees. So that's where, that's an advantage of a covered call. So similarly, stocks like high dividend yielding stocks, like, you know, you want to hold or you want to own it at a, even if the price falls. Say, for example, again, this is a dividend yielding stock. So if the price comes to 210 or 10 rupees, you don't mind buying this particular stock. Okay, but by doing this strategy, say for example, you want to sell this particular strategy of a February contract at 210, the put option price is six rupees. Okay, so you can reduce your cost by 6 rupees if the price does not go below 210. Okay, and if the price, even if the price goes below 210, you can reduce your cost by six rupees. If the price remains above 210, you still gain that. So that's an advantage that you have. Okay. So it's like a way of earning some kind of a dividend itself. So if the price falls, it's good for you because your dividend yield for that particular stock is also going to go up. You know? So that's how you can use this particular strategies to gain additional investment. Okay. So I'm now open to questions. Any questions that you have, you can ask me. I think, Ajay, how are you going to do it?
Yeah, so what they can do is in the chat box, they can type out and okay. We will
or,
so
that. Yeah, they, or they can raise a hand and ask the question as well. So.
So let me start with the first question. From your experience, what kind of risks do you think options entail to a regular investor?
Yeah, so as if you're looking at, see, there are two ways to look at the option market. One, as I mean, these two strategies that if you're going to use it, okay? I would say you're using the strategies just like your stock investment. If you buy a stock, you'll definitely have a risk, right? Okay, so I'm saying if you buy a stock and if you do a covered call, for example, you could reduce your cost by regularly doing this. So it's one way of, like, you know, you don't know whether the stock price, if after you bought the stock, you don't know whether the stock price will go up, okay, that you expect, right? Okay, so if the price falls, you'll always have a risk there. Okay, so suppose you bought a stock at 100, okay, you may be expecting 105, okay, but the stock fell. So you'll always have a risk.
So you're saying it's important to have a strategy rather than to naked calls, naked puts up or calls.
Yeah. So one second. Yeah, I think I'll stop sharing my screen. So. Yeah. So yeah. So the risk is, like, you know, there are if you're looking at it as an investment and you want to use your portfolio, I would say one must use this particular options trading to get additional return on investment. So as I told you, both these strategies can be used very well. If you are having on your portfolio, you can use covered call as a strategy. Okay. So many a times what happens is that when we buy a stock, the price of the stock, we know that it will not go to the extent that we were expecting within a month, right? I mean, we are looking at the stocks which has happened in the last, forget about the last 1.5 year of rally, okay? But otherwise, you'll not see such kind of a movement in the stock market, right? These are exceptional rallies that you've seen. Okay.
Yeah, during budget time or when there are big swings.
So what happens is that on a regular market condition, the stock price in a year could move only 10%, 20%, 30%. You know, it does not move 300, 500%. Okay. So in such cases, when you know that the price of the stock is not going to go beyond a certain price, okay, or if the delta tells you that, you know, this is where the delta is below 30, which is an indication that the probability of price reaching that is about 30%. Those are the levels that you can use to sell this particular call option. Okay. So same way, we want to own a stock. Okay. But the price is too high currently. So in this case, you can still participate and buy this stock at the price that you want to buy. But if the price does not come to the level that you want to buy, you still gain from this by the buy of premium. So this is another strategy. So when I say, if you saw just now in ITC, right? So a February contract having a 210 strike price, having a premium, 215 strike price, having a premium of 6 rupees, okay? Which is almost 3% return per month, right? If you look at it.
Yeah.
Even if you invest on that particular stock every month consistently, if you get $6, 6 rupees or whatever, it's almost 2%, 3% per month that you can gain. Okay.
Yeah.
So that is where you can use the strategies. Now, when it comes to trading, if you're purely using it as a trading option strategy, as a trading opportunity, then you can participate in this market, which requires some kind of a risk management by way of hedging your options. Suppose you buy a call at say a particular price and sell a call of that higher price. So you know, even if the price goes higher to a certain level, you are protected that way. So you have to use a lot of strategies, which I think today is not the day to discuss that actually. So.
Yeah. So Adrian has a question. How can you play budget day using options? What would your proposal be? Now he suggests buying the 17-200 call for everyone else. The spot is at 17-100. So buying the 17-200 call, selling the 17-750 call, and selling a 16-500 put.
It all depends on what kind of, if you're looking at as a strategy. So even if
what he's saying is there would be a huge swing on budget day. So would this play into a huge swing?
Yeah. So normally people if you're expecting say 2000 point swing in Nifty, for example, or 1000 point swing in Nifty. Okay. So, and if this at the money straddle, for example, so selling a call and a put is quoting only at 500 rupees. Obviously, if you're expecting a swing of 1000 points, you definitely gain from this, right? Because if the market moves that kind of a swing. So that is how you can that's how you can use it. But again, budget days are very, very we don't know what happens actually, what kind of announcements.
It's for the speculator.
You are prepared to this thing, but yeah, you can always you can sell a straddle and buy a call of call and put options of a low far out of the money as well, so that you can protect the risk that you have to a certain extent, right? So if the market moves one-sided, if you're selling, fine, no problem. But if the market, if you're selling, you'll have a risk that way, right? If you're buying, no problem.
For a person who's entering the market in options now, fresh, he's dealt with equity. He understands how equity moves. He understands charting technicals. How important would you say it is for him to understand theta, delta, and Black-Scholes pricing?
No, I see. I'll tell you what happens normally is, there is a little bit of learning to do, okay? But when one need not worry about how the options are priced. Like say, when you see a price of certain price for the option, one need not worry so much, because if there is an imperfection in the pricing, obviously there are arbitrage opportunities. You know, the machines, the automatic algos that run today will not allow you to gain that extra this thing. So they are, according to me, they are priced perfectly at any given condition. So one need not worry about it so much, but at the same time, it is important to look at implied volatility, theta. It's very important for you to know, because depending on what kind of a strategy you are doing it. Suppose you are a seller of an option, you need a higher implied volatility times that you need, so that if the volatility decreases also. Say, for example, if you are, many a times what happens during the company results, right? For example, okay? The volatility of a stock increases drastically, okay? But the moment the results are announced, okay, the volatility reduces because there is no uncertainty. The uncertainty is already known to the people. Before the results, we don't know the uncertainty. So same thing will happen closer to now we are closer to the budget. We will see the implied volatility going up drastically, which means as a seller, you are at an advantage. If there is nothing big in this budget and if the market does not move, suddenly the implied volatility itself, reduction in the implied volatility itself will gain you a lot of money, you know. So I see Clarence, questions from Clarence. I just showed the example of US markets because US as well as Indian markets as well, because I thought there will be people from UAE as well who have an access to trade the US markets. So yes, you can, as an Indian, you cannot, as a resident Indian, you cannot participate in the options market from here. But yeah, those who are in the UAE can still use US markets to trade. And they can trade in the Indian markets.
Hello, can we speak?
Go ahead. Go ahead. Yes.
Yes. So I would like to share some personal experience on this. So first of all, Roshan, thanks a lot. Very informative. And and the gentleman whom you know, Norbert Chinoy, he spoke highly of you. So I told him that I'm entering your webinar, and he was very thrilled. So I've done a little bit of options with him called covered options. Okay. And I don't mind sharing a little bit of success with it. I started about 2 years back. I put in about 11 lakh rupees. And of course, with NRI, there are restrictions as such in terms of how much you can leverage or how much you can take. A couple of months back, I put another 5 lakhs. So overall, I had invested about 16 lakhs on covered options. He has been doing it as a favor, basically. Okay. He's not charging me any commissions or any kind of success fee or anything of that sort. But my portfolio has actually gone from 16 lakhs to, if I have to say, about to 30 lakhs today.
Okay.
So he's done some, and what he's also done is like covered calls, like he bought Coal India, like it was 13. He had to take delivery. You took it, and you know the shares went up to 160, 170. And I'm happy with the dividends. I'm happy to hold on with the shares. He's also went with Asian Paints and other things. So, even when there were the put options, you had to buy those put, at the time, and then it went up so you made money. So basically what he says is, listen, you've got to treat it like in brackets, I don't want to use the word, but also don't get attached to the share. And secondly, he said, go for the good shares as such, So he's put in a challenge for me. Look, you got to learn about it. I haven't learned much about it, but he's done a great. But the reason why I'm sharing this experience is the rewards, I think, are far greater than a bank deposit or any other kind of investment if you do it wisely, if you're willing to take risk, and if you are willing to invest in good shares. He said, look, even if it goes down, it's going to come up anyway, so don't worry about that, sir. So given the fact that with that kind of thing, which are there, I think it's a very good avenue to have basically a lot of passive income. If you have a little bit of liquidity. So what I did was actually, I said, look, and this is what we started recently is, look, I've got some big fixed deposit. I've taken an OD on that as well. If required, I need cash. I can always pump in as well, whichever that's required. So, you could take a little more risk and say, so hopefully, and that's number one. Number two, what I learned from him is that if you have your shares, good shares, and you rightly pointed Apple shares and all, you can actually make a lot of money even without really getting rid of it, if you are willing to let go of it. And then he said, even if you had to let go of it, next time you put in put option, you know, and get it back if required. You know, that's how you can do it. You know, you play around with it. So if you're feeling in love with a share, you can always buy it back, you know, and then play around with the game itself. So that's something which is very, very, I think, profound feedback. Only thing is, you got to learn a bit on this, he said. There are courses. I haven't gone.
Yeah, there are plenty of courses.
Actually, what Roshan shared just now is just scratching the surface. You know, we'll all have to go back and hit the books, and the options are, and derivatives is huge.
You can easily make 25 to 30% profit, you know, per annum.
You can also lose 20 to 30% if you're not wise and careful with the way you plan your strategies. So that's what Roshan's here for. Are there any more questions from anyone else? Because I think we're running short on time. There is one more question from someone else. They're asking, what are the common traps a trader should guard against?
What do you say? As a trader, I think if you are looking at as a trader, then we'll have to have a separate session for that. I mean, those who are interested to do as a trading strategy. But yes, as I said, you know, anybody who wants to trade as options, one has to do covered options whenever you're doing options, like so that you are not exposed to unlimited risk. The advantage of selling options is you are at a very big advantage at any given point of time. Theoretically the risk looks unlimited, okay, but selling option would be a wise advice that I would give, which means that even if you are expecting the market stock price is going to go trade neutral, or not going to go up much up and down, better to do selling of an option by hedging the risk. So at a higher of a higher strike or lower strike, depending on what
you basically absorb the volatility.
Yeah, so volatility as well as say, suppose you are bullish about a stock. Okay, you are bullish about a stock. So what you can do is that you can sell a call, right? Sell a put, right? Because you're bullish about that particular stock. Okay. So your gain, if the price falls, okay, so you'll gain on volatility
and you'll gain on theta also.
Yeah, that is another thing that you'll gain. But you know, we don't know how much it can go up or go down, right? When you do a trade, so it's always advisable to have some kind of a price point that you are not willing to take a risk on. Okay, so in such cases, it is important to create a strategy in such a way that it is hedge strategy with every trade that you do, so that your risk will not be, even if you're a seller for an option, your risk is not unlimited. Your risk is known to you well in advance. So, and you should be, if you know your risk well in advance, then it is your call whether you are willing to take that risk or not before you enter a trade.
So
that is what you need to, I would advise anybody who wants to do options purely from a trading point of view. But today's session was mainly towards how you can gain from this using your portfolio or even your, how you can build your portfolio. That was the intention here. And case you need any help from me, advice from me, do reach out to me. I think
we will definitely need another session maybe in the near future, because this has piqued everyone's interest. I see we have a number of 27, which is small but a focused number of people who have attended this webinar. We have people from Dubai and Bangalore here, so we will definitely need another session, Roshan. I think
surely we can do that. And if anybody wants some kind of help on this or some kind of a question, so you can always reach out to me. I think my number is available on the KE.
Maybe you can even share your presentation so that
I will do that.
We'll take care of that. Thanks so much, Roshan, for this webinar. And thanks everyone from Dubai and Bangalore who have attended this on a Saturday night. It's 9:45 in Bangalore and probably about 8:15 in Dubai. So enjoy the rest of your Saturday, what is left.
And thanks a lot to everyone for attending this and hearing me patiently. And do let me know if you need any help from me.
Sure. Thanks everyone. Good night.
Good night.